This is a Psyframe deck profile, so be prepared for a lot of Zolt.
Hashtag prepare!
Alright, you guys, so this is going to be my take on Psyframes. This is not going to be a combo-centric deck profile. This is actually an anti-meta deck profile. I wanted to make Psyframes even more anti-meta than they already are. I mean, it's already hand-trapped the deck, but I also wanted to add some floodgates and things that I wish I would have played at the last regional that I went to. And I was playing set rotations in this deck, but that got hit to one. That was just too good. It was too good of a card, guys. But that set rotation did kind of hit the way I played the deck, but I replaced it, you know, with a new trap card that we got. I think you guys know what it is, so it's all fine and good. I just really wanted to show you guys this deck because I actually really like playing it. I know a lot of people hate this deck, but it is very anti-meta. I made it my own by making it even more anti-meta than it already is, and I just have a lot of fun playing it, so I hope that you enjoy this deck profile. All right, so starting with the monsters, you have your three Psyframe Gear Gamma. This one is the effect negator. All Psyframes more or less, you know, do the same thing. You know, they negate something or they stop something. They do something and then bring out like a driver, you know, from hand, deck, or graveyard, and that's just all they do, you know what I mean? And if you have the field spell up, then you immediately synchro summon on your opponent's turn, which is actually phenomenal, especially with stuff like Black Rose. You can Black Rose on your opponent's turn. This deck is very, very control based. It is literally hand trapped the deck, which makes it very, very control, very anti-meta, which is why I like playing it. But you know, Gamma is the effect negator. Delta is debatably better than Gamma. It depends on the matchup. This card's really good against, you know, activated field spells, against, I mean, just anything. If you're playing against Fluffles, you know, just random example, you know, hit their Poly, you know, hit their, you know, Fright for Fusion, you know, all that stuff. Like, Delta is just a fantastic card, you know, negates any spell, and then you bring out a driver, and if you have the field spell up, you go into Omega, and then Omega, you know, takes away a card from your opponent. Same thing with Gamma, you know, effect negator, and then, you know, your spell negator. And then next up, you have what keeps you alive, the Beta. Beta negates an attack and ends the battle phase, which really keeps you alive, lets you go into a level 7 synchro. This one's pretty good. Alpha is probably the worst. You activate this when your opponent normal or special summons, you know, just any monster, and this gives you a search, which is good. That's like its redeeming quality, but it's a level 1. It doesn't let you go into Omega, you into like Zeta or, you know, Black Rose or something like that with it. But Alpha is, I mean, it's a good card, you know, because it lets you search, but you have to play it. Like, you have to play it. Like, Gamma and Delta are the vastly superior Psyframes, you know what I mean? I mean, it's just common sense. Like, you know, effect negation's really good, spell negation's really good, attack negation's pretty good, and then, you know, Alpha, which just kind of keeps the deck afloat, is just kind of like the worst Psyframe, but they're all needed. Like, they're all really good cards. And then I only play two driver. The third one never really comes up. I was playing three, and I was playing, you know, multi-threader and stuff. I actually cut multi-threader from the deck completely because, you know, you really want to protect your field spell and everyone, you know, if anyone's playing spell and trap destruction, they're playing, you know, Cosmic Cyclones anyways, which isn't spell and trap destruction. Cosmic Cyclone banishes, guys, so multi-threader isn't really protecting anything. Multi-threader, I feel like, is just better in the more combo-centric Psyframe builds that I have seen, and that's just fine. If you want to play a more combo-centric, you know, Psyframe build, that is just fine. This is just the anti-meta control build that I came up with, you know, to each their own. And then that is all for the Psyframe monsters, though. That is, what, 3, 6, 9, 12, 14 Psyframe monsters, and then you have your card-cardies. Card-cardie is a +1, plus he gets around your mistake. I'm not playing Droll and Locks, I'm main decking mistake, because I feel like it's just so much more of a powerful card, and there's so many decks that search, but I'll get into that, you know, later in the profile. But card-cardie gets around that, you know, lets you draw, it doesn't search, you know. Then I play a 3 Ash Blossoms, speaking of searching, so your opponent can't search. They activate Terraforming, they activate anything, they activate Brilliant Fusion, I mean, they activate just anything, you know, Pot of Desires even, you stop it. Like, no, nothing from the deck for your opponent. Ash Blossom is a fantastic card, and this has already hand-trapped the deck, and adding more hand-trap stopping power to this deck, it just makes it, it sends it over the top, okay? It really sends it over the top, makes this deck really, really fun to play, gives this deck a lot of stopping power going first or second. And speaking of going second, you want to play that Max C, which is the last monster in the deck, because you get to draw so many cards, you know what I mean? You can draw, you know, Gammas, you can draw Deltas, you can draw, you know, all that stuff, draw your field spell if you haven't, you know, seen your field spell yet. Just, you know, anything, see an Ash, you know, or if your opponent doesn't, you know, go for the Max C challenge, you just stop them in their tracks. So Max C is a fantastic card. And, you know, like I was saying just a minute ago, this has already hand-trapped the deck. Adding more hand-traps gives you so much stopping power going first or second. So now for the spell cards, guys, you play the best spell card that you can play. It's the Psyframe Circuit. This makes your deck go. You cannot win without this card, guys. It's very, very important. I mean, going second, this deck can go second. It does have stopping power going second, you know, because of all the hand traps you play. But Psyframe Circuit going first, you know, getting this circuit up, getting, you know, that negate off of your Psyframes or whatever, maybe drop an Ash, and then being able to make an Omega on their turn or, you know, anything on their turn after that is just really, really good. Psyframe Circuit allows you to do that. Plus, it is an attack booster. Do not forget that. That helps you get over so many things, especially if you, you know, you hard draw into a driver, giving your monster, you know, that 2500 boost off of the circuit is pretty good. Plus driver, you know, special summons itself from the graveyard, you know, hand deck or graveyard based on your Psyframe monsters. So that's really, really good. And then I play 3 Fuel Zone. Fuel Zone to me is the superior card to Psychic Path. Even though Psychic Path can be a +1 out of your banish pile, Fuel Zone gives you a monster. Fuel Zone gives you a monster, which is really, really good. It gets you an Omega, you know what I mean? It gets you like an Omega or Zeta or your other, you know, your Overmind Archfiend, like your really big guy. But those are your targets. And technically, you can go into Life Trance or you can go into, you know, all that other stuff I play in the extra deck, which I'll get to later. But Fuel Zone, it's just, to me, it's a superior card. You know, it's a way superior card over the Psychic Path. I just feel like it's way, way better. And then 3 Pot of Duality. This is going to wrap up the spells. I only play 9 spells. My main deck mistake, which sucks with Duality, but you want to open. Like, basically, I was playing in previous builds. I was playing, you know, Foolish Burial of Goods to, you know, hit the trap card and being able to search. I was playing, you know, Terraforming some previous builds and stuff. But what I did is I just decided to main deck more Floodgates and more Hate and just bump the spells down to the essentials, just the bare essentials, which is like the Field Spell, the Field Zone, and then the Pot of Duality. So you want to open up Pot of Duality and, you know, with the mistake or whatever and get the Duality out of the way before your mistake is live, because once your mistake is live and your opponent doesn't get rid of it, view hard draw into Duality, it does suck, but opening with Duality is fantastic and you want to go first with this deck. You really, really want to go first. And that's something that I kind of did with this deck, is I made an anti-meta deck that, you know, it obviously prefers to go first, but it can go second because of all the hand traps. That's pretty much what I did. And I was able to accomplish that by just simplifying the spell lineup and everything else. But now on to the traps. You play the 3 Psyframe Overload, which is amazing. This, you know, you don't care if this gets destroyed. You don't want it to get banished, you know, off a Cosmic Cyclone. But, you know, Psyframe Overload is a fantastic card. If it does hit the graveyard, you get a search, you know, not the turn that it's sent to the graveyard, which kind of sucks, but you do get a search. You get to banish it from your graveyard and get a search. Plus with Omega, you can put this back in your graveyard, you know what I mean, and then rebanish and get another search, which is really, really, really good. Psyframe Overload is a fantastic card. Plus, this is like a really good control card, because banishing your opponent's stuff face down is just great. It lets you keep, you know, complete control over your opponent along with your hand traps and along with your floodgates and along with your Omega, you know, with all those things combined, you get to completely control your opponents. Plus, you know, Overload, it outs everything. It really outs everything. It's just a great, great trap card. And then since we got a set rotation, you know, put to 1, I put in 3 Metaverse. What you do is you like chain this, you make this like, basically you make like a gamma, like chain link 2 negating your opponent's, you know, monster effect, for example. And then you make this a chain link 3. So the Metaverse comes out, puts the field spell out, gamma negates, you know, and then negates your opponent's monster. Then on a separate chain, your field spell activates, and that lets you synchro summon. So that's how you resolve the Metaverse properly. Metaverse is just, it's just a really good card, you know, going first. It's really what beefs up the trap lineup. You know, I was playing, you know, 3 set rotation and like the Oracle of Zephyr, which sucked to draw the Zephyr because it was like hard drawing a Garnet playing the Brilliant Tension, but just playing the set rotation was really good. It gave you technically like another negate in the deck, but this is also very good. Metaverse is also a very, very good card. And then another really good card is Mistake. A lot of decks search right now. This says no to that, and it's just a really great Floodgate card, and it's just a really good card. Like, you kind of win. That's something I regretted, you know, in the last regional, which was under Spiral format, granted, but you know, I just sided this in. I was siding 3 of this, and I kept, you know, putting 3 in the main every game 2. Like, every game 2, I was putting this into the main, and I regretted not main decking this, so I'm rectifying that now. A lot of decks, even though Spirals have gotten hit, Spirals are still a deck. Invoked is still a deck, guys. You know, so many decks are still decks. The only thing that this doesn't really hurt is, like, Paleo, which sucks, but you could just side this out, you know what I mean? Side this out for Paleo. I mean, how often do you really play against Paleo anyways? I mean, I guess it just depends on what locals you go to and all that stuff. But yeah, I feel like for the most part, though, 3 Mistake is just a great call. That's just how I feel. And then I was 1 card short, okay? I was 1 card short. I was, you know, thinking Upstart Goblin. I was thinking about putting the Foolish Burial of Goods back, but if you draw the goods and the Mistake is already up, you know, that kind of sucks. So then I was thinking Upstart Goblin. But then, like, Upstart Goblin, I mean, it lets you draw a card, but you give your opponent, like, 1,000 life points. And I really wasn't going for that, especially because Psyframes, it can be really hard to get life points, you know, on your opponent, you know, life point damage in on your opponent anyway. So I just decided to get a Skill Drain. I decided to go with another Floodgate, and I haven't haven't regretted it. Skill Drain just wins you games, like, on its own sometimes, because you just, like, flip this, and your opponent, I mean, all your monsters are hand traps, you know what I mean? And card tributes itself, so it gets around Skill Drain. So yeah, basically, if you open up with an Omega and a Skill Drain, and, like, I don't know, like a Mistake, or, you know, just something else, you know what I mean? If you open up with an Omega, you know, you negate something, and then get out an Omega with the field spell, and then you have a Skill Drain, you basically win, because your opponent's not going to be able to out 2800 attack, you know, which just, like, their monsters and stuff, like their main deck monsters, they're probably not going to be able to do it. They're going to need a Raigeki or something. So yeah, Skill Drain is just a fantastic card. It wins you games single-handedly. Skill Drain, guys, is just one of the best floodgates of all time, and that being said, I mean, if you can main deck it, why not main deck it? Alright, so on to the extra deck now. You play 2 Omega and 3 Zeta. These are your Psyframe monsters. This one, you know, being the level 7, this one being the level 8. Omega is definitely the better out of the two, but Zeta, it can be a pain in the dick for your opponent, because, you know, you can just, like, tap this out and banish a special summon monster. You know, even temporarily can be a huge pain for your opponent. This is very disruptive. It's a very, very good card. Not as good as Omega, you know, because robbing cards from your opponent's hand before they can even use them is, you know, obviously way, way better. But Zeta is still a really good card. Plus, you know, its ability does, you know, tag out and keep your hand traps usable, because, you know, all of your side frames require you to have no monsters on the field. So Zeta does its job. I feel like this should be another level 7 side frame, but that's just how I feel about it. And then Scarlight, because Scarlight's, it could be a board wipe. It's 3,000 attack, guys. 3,000 attack with the Skill Drain up. You're not gonna lose this monster, okay? And they have to have a Dark Hole or a Raigeki or a Kaiju or something like that. But Scrap Dragon, because this guy can pop itself and get itself off the field, which is really, really good. You know, pop itself, pop an opponent's card, and then keep your side frames live. That's just really good. Scrap Dragon is a great card. Plus, it's 2,800 attack, and that's nothing to complain about. And then a Thought Ruler Archfiend, great for getting life points back. It's just kind of like a level 8 synchro that you have to play. And then Black Rose Dragon, which is really, I use this like MVP against Pendulums, like a lot. I use this a lot against Pendulums and stuff, because they have so many cards on field. And a Black Rose Dragon just wipes the board completely. And yeah, it's just that. It's a board wipe. It's a complete and utter board wipe. The only thing that sucks is when you use this and you have like a field spell up, you lose your field spell, but depending on your hand, it's like not that big of a deal. So other than that though, Black Rose Dragon is nothing but beneficial to this deck. It's a fantastic card. And then I play a Clear Wing. Clear Wing, guys, is just really good against any deck that plays big monsters. It's a fantastic card. And then I play a Psychic Life Trancer, because this helps you gain life points back against, you know, Trick Stars and stuff, as does the Thought Ruler Archfiend. These two, actually in this format, you know, against Trick Stars and all that, these two cards can be very important, you know, keeping you alive. So keep that in mind, you know, gaining life points back. Crimson Blader, this should be a Yazi, Evil of the Yang Zing. That's what this should be, but I don't have one, so it's just a Crimson Blader, because I couldn't think of a, you know, looking through all my synchros and stuff, I couldn't think of a better synchro to play, so I just put in Crimson Blader. It's probably not the best. What is kind of good though, when you do get it off, you don't get it off very often, but this is a move that the deck can play, and this does, you know, have a lot of extra deck room. So you play the Ancient Fairy Dragon and the Crystal Wing, if you guys don't know how that works. So let's just say you have, you know, an alpha in hand, your opponent summons something, you have the field spell up, you go into Ancient Fairy Dragon, and then you use alpha to search out, you know, a level 1 tuner, right? That works. And then let's just say Ancient Fairy Dragon lives, because it's got 3,000 booty, and then, you know, not to mention that 2,100 attack. What you could do is that tuner that you searched, you can go ahead, or if you already had a tuner, you can use Ancient Fairy Dragon's effect, you know, summon that level 1 tuner, and then go into Crystal Wing. So it doesn't go off, you know, that often, but it is an option in the deck, and Crystal Wing is a fantastic card. I mean, and the Ancient Fairy, it's just a good card. It's just a really good card. Plus, you can go into, like, you know, any other level 8 synchro or whatever. Ancient Fairy Dragon just kind of bridges that, you know, gap in the extra deck. And then Overmind Archfiend, you should probably play the Psychic Blaster instead. Overmind Archfiend is the better card, though. But either way, both of those cards you go into off of the Psychic Field Zone. It doesn't happen very often. I made this guy a couple of times. Actually, once I made it 2 times in one match. But that's just very, very rare. It doesn't happen all that often. But it is a fantastic card. You know, it banishes cards. And then if this guy is sent to the graveyard, he special summons all the banished, you know, monsters, all the banished Psychic monsters that you banish from your graveyard. So he can, you know, get you a pretty beefy field if he ever leaves the field, if his effect keeps going. Plus, he's 3,300. Attack and 3,000 def. His stats are huge. So yeah, I'm really happy with this extra deck. I think it's really, really solid, except for the Crimson Blader. I mean, Crimson Blader is a very good card. It can, you know, win you games against certain decks and stuff, but not right now, I feel like. And Crimson Blader is just not as good as Yazi, in my opinion, in this deck, because Yazi also gets itself off the field, similar to Scrap Dragon, so it just has better synergy with Psyframes. To the side deck, you side a 3 Gamer Seal, because going second in this deck is made much, much easier, much, much better, you know, siding this guy. It's just the best kaiju to side, you know, it's really good. It's the smallest attack. Three Lancia against, you know, evenly matched, against Invoked, against, you know, Cosmos, technically, against ABC, technically as well. Lancia is just a fantastic card, and this is hand trap the deck, like I've been saying, and, you know, this is another good hand trap that you could play, so it's a really, really good card. Speaking of hand traps, my side two Ghost Ogres, this is also a really, really good hand trap to side. I was maining this, but, you know, the deck changed, you know, with set rotation and everything, you know, being limited, and just the deck itself kind of had to change, I felt like, you know, to combat the new meta. When this was more, you know, just pure Spiral Hate the deck, you know, before the format changed, I main decked the Ghost Ogres because this is just a really, really good card. But I side these eight monsters, only one spell. I side just one Raigeki. This is like the last card I added to the side deck, and I only added it because, you know, thinking about it, I was like, I kind of want another card going second sometimes, and that's why I added it. But yeah, that's the only reason why I side it. You could technically put in Dark Hole if you wanted to, just to be able to wipe your own monsters. I mean, technically, that is another card you can choose. You could play, you know, one Twin Twisters. I don't know. You know, this slot is just the last slot that I could think of, and I felt like this is like the least important slot. I felt like everything else was pretty straightforward, pretty covered, especially this. This is three Mask of Restrict because, you know, there's gonna be some True Draco stuff running around, and this doesn't have the best out to masterpiece. Like, I mean, it actually doesn't have any out to masterpiece, like, at all. So, you know, you take out your mistakes, and then you put in your Mask of Restricts, and that outs, you know, that keeps masterpiece from even getting out on the board in the first place. And then three Try and Guess. This comes up a lot more than you think. This deck goes in the time a lot. This card right here, siding this in, has won me a lot of matches. I mean, at least, I want to say, I mean, I'm serious, like, at least six matches in time, this has won me games, okay? Or, like, you know, your matches online, you know, they're timed and stuff. This is just one. This is just such a really good card. If you guys do not know what this does, you and your opponent reveal your extra deck, you know, you call Xyz Synchro or whatever, and whoever has the most, you know, gets 3,000 life points. And this plays 15 Synchros in the extra deck, so you get the 3,000 life points, because no one else is going to be playing 15 Synchros. This is just a really, really great card, guys. You know, it wins games, makes people salty, but, you know, but a win is a win. A win is a win. I actually got this idea. I forgot the guy's name, but he played Try and Guess. He sided three of this in side frames in 2016, the 2016 Nats, the one that Monarchs won. I really honestly cannot remember his name, but shout out to that guy, because if he wasn't siding this card then, I would not be siding this card now, because I would never, ever think of this card, and it's actually really, really good. But yeah, really quick, guys, let's do one or two test hands. I want to show off, you know, how much stomping power this deck can have going first, you know, because opening up with Gamma and the field spell is very, very good. That is very powerful and gets you to an Omega, you know, on your opponent's turn. But opening up that with like a Floodgate and a Hand Trap is just insane. Like, it is really, really good. Let's see what we draw in our first hand. So not too good, but we did get the Circuits and then, you know, Ash Blossom. This is what I'm saying. This is exactly what I'm saying. This Driver could have been something else. You know, opening up Driver with this deck is bad. Every deck kind of has like their bad hands, you know, opening up Driver in this deck isn't the best. I mean, you can always banish it, you know, off of the trap and stuff. But yeah, like I'm saying though, like, every deck has like their bad hands, but this is actually a pretty good hand because this is the field spell plus a Gamma plus an Omega, you know, and it's a Joyous Spring on top of that. So you have literally all the stopping power on your opponent's turn. That's really, really good. Let's open up one more. Let's not draw the Driver this time. But opening up, you know, two Field Zone or whatever is equally bad. Opening up multiple Metaverse though is not bad at all because you can just add the field spell to your hand instead, which is pretty good. So either way, I mean, it gives you the option to search or to activate the field spell, which is really, really good. All right, so let's cut this in half again. Not open up a Driver. There we go. Okay, so that's a little better. So we have the Field Spell, Maxi, Ash Blossom, Pot of Duality. So what we're going to try to do is score. There we go. What we're going to try to do is try to score a Psyframe monster, and you take your pick. Like, if you know you're going against something that doesn't play a whole lot of spells, you know, or plays less spells, for example, you know, go for Gamma. If you think you're playing against something, you know, like Fluffle, or what for, you know, random example, like Fluffle that plays a lot of spells, add the Delta. And plus, this is a Maxi. A Mistake, an Ash Blossom, and a Circuit. Like, I mean, this hand is just very, very powerful. This also, you know, demonstrates why you play, you know, three Pot of Duality with a Mistake, because if you open up both of these, it's just fine. You know, it's just fine because you just set this, you know, you've already got this out of the way, and just activate this on your opponent's turn. Your next card, yeah, I was about to say, like, your next card, I mean, you would shuffle or whatever, but I mean, your next card's probably not going to be a Duality. I mean, because your chances, since you drew one, your chances go down of drawing it, you know what I mean? But yeah, that's exactly what I wanted to show you. just, you know, demonstrate exactly how much stopping power this deck has. But yeah, guys, I really hope that you enjoyed this deck. This deck is very, very fun to play. It is very, very control. If you like playing control decks, if you like playing hand traps and all that stuff, you know, if you like playing floodgates, this is the deck for you. Because when you play this deck, right, guys, I'm not even kidding. This might be the most controlliest deck, if that's even a word, controlliest. This might be the controlliest deck that I have ever played. But I have plenty more deck profiles coming your way very, very soon, so be on the lookout for those. And until next time, guys, be sure to dick slap that like button and subscribe.
Subscribe!